cards up. As you can see, I have a new little device there on the dash, so I can hold my phone, I can record my videos. So currently it is show day for NABBA. Carrying on from the other video I did, basically what I did yesterday, I had a minimal amount of carbs. I did have some carbs in the end, but basically what I followed up and did was I dried out. So basically I'll be coming in drier than the last show. I basically went to bed and did a diuretic, woke up and repeated the process in the morning. I cut my water there at 10 last night. So basically all that's left to do today is to try to not spill. Obviously my sodium is still present, but I am going to pick up some salt from the petrol station anyway, and I am going to pick up a bottle of Lucozade, and just for, you know, worst to worst if I start cramping. And then I am going to just eat, enjoy the show. I'm driving to my friend's house, he's driving me down to the show itself, and then we are going to just enjoy the process. So I have a bag of food in the back, obviously. I have my CD in the back. And this bag is filled with goodies, as well as, you know, what I'm actually going to be eating before the stage show. Basically, rice cakes with yogurt and chocolate. Yogurt and orange, sorry. And then turkey. I'm just going to graze on that throughout the day. I'm going to pick up some flapjacks and stuff like that. Just some more complex carbohydrates that aren't really dirty or sugary, and we'll just munch on those throughout the day. But obviously if I'm not hungry, I'm not going to eat, like, you know, I'm not going to force feed it, because I just want to fill up the muscle as best as I can. But my party piece, as I said earlier, is my waistline. So if my waistline is blown out and I can't do vacuums, I can't hold it in, it takes away from my whole physique. And like, I was watching a Lee Priest video with Dave Palumbo the other day, and a lot of mistakes that people do is, you know, they overeat. So it's like they fill up the muscle, but they're under this illusion that, you know, you need to eat to fill up the muscle. But if you're under, like myself, good example, when I was fully depleted, when I was fully depleted, I was down to 74.5 kilos, okay? I went and had Tommy have a look at me after I ate a little bit. Woke up at 77. I looked pretty damn good at 77, nice and dry and separated. So I just wanted to push it a little bit further. So basically yesterday after the carb up, on Friday, I was 79.8, so basically 80 kilos. And then this morning I woke up and I was 77.8 kilos. So basically I am now at that sweet spot. I was 79.8 kilos yesterday in the morning after being all carved up and stuff. Then I slowly depleted throughout the day anyway. Went to bed at around 79, and then I woke up and I was 78.6. So again, when I saw Tommy, yeah, I was 77.6. So at this point I'm a kilo above where I looked pretty, you know. Tommy said just fill out that little bit more, So obviously I'm in that area now. If I fill up too much, it blurs detail. If I deplete much further, I will lose my roundness and fullness and stuff like that. So I'm in that sweet spot now. And the thing is, this is a warm-up show for me. Obviously, I want to win it. It's the NABBA Mr Ireland. It's the Blue Shinners tribute show. So obviously, I want to win the damn thing. But at the same time, I'm under no illusions that I'm going to be the most conditioned guy up there. But what I do have is from the front and from the side and certain shots from the back, I will be very, 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 very good as long as I am it's spilled over. My tan will be on the money, because I paid for someone to do my top coat, and I have glaze with me and I have gloves with me, so I am going to leave none up to chance today. So yeah, I'm just trying to maintain that fullness. Obviously with the diuretic this morning, that stays in the system throughout the day anyway, so I am going to lose water weight, so obviously I have to counteract that water weight by eating food. I'm just going by feel, basically. I don't have a coach, but I was lucky enough to have Tommy Staunton look at me throughout last week. So I think, look, no matter what the outcome is, this package is going to be better than last week. And you know, it's just a case of, what do the judges want? Where do they want to put me? So I actually had a really good sleep last night. I woke up at like 2:30. Had a really good look at myself, hit my poses, and was getting drier. Then I woke up this morning at 7, which is great. So I actually got a good few hours. So obviously, because I'm not on till 6, I can basically just relax for the day, pose, and just dry out, you know? So I'm just going to enjoy the process and I'll fill you in as we keep on going. But thanks very much, guys, for the support, of course. I hope I do you so proud. Alright, so I'm getting driven down to NABBA, my friend Aaron. I think registration is at 10 for men's physique, men's bodybuilding. 10 to 10:30. The show starts at 11. So basically, in between the last vlog, in the last recording, I just got some pancakes, nothing on them, and I got 2 sachets of salt for sodium.
Roll up.
And then basically, we have just go to the registration, sit down, relax, watch the show. There's a big difference between this morning and last morning, anyway. In the last show, like, I'm not worried at all about spilling or, you know, looking watery or anything. Like, I've taken the steps to ensure that, absolutely. And because I'm not on until 6, it's literally just a case of, if I'm hungry, eat. If I'm not hungry, I'm not going to worry about it, because I don't want to blow up my waist. But talking about NABBA, basically it's a tribute show to one of the judges who died. Basically it will be a big show. Regards who's in my class, there's only 2 of note. There's a guy who bent me last week, so I am going to try and beat him. That's my only thing, I just want to beat him. I'm under no doubts I can, when it all falls into place. In terms of the other person, it is a bodybuilder called Billy Bourne from the north, who won the NABBA Universe 2005 and Worlds Freak. But it's his comeback, so will he be at his best? We don't know. He hasn't stuck up any pictures, so there's nothing. So I'll just see him backstage or at the show or even now at registration, that'll be it. But to be honest, it's more just an honor to be. If I get first call out with him, I'm happy enough. If I get to stand beside him and trade shots with him, like, I mean, he'll be bigger than me, but you know, I have the waist, I have the arms, I have the quads, I have certain body parts, but he'll be on the money. But we'll see what happens. So my aim for this is top 2, get qualified for the universe, which is on the 2nd of November. And then we'll just enjoy the show. I'll record some more stuff when we're there. My old coach is coming out, so I'll be hanging with him for a bit. My dad will be coming out later on, and then one of my friends will be coming out later on. So we'll have some fun and relax and catch up, and I'll try and get some characters on the video as well, so it won't just be me talking. Alright guys, so we are all registered. Class 3. So I am now just off. I'm just going to get some breakfast. Just fill out now today, basically. I'm not until 6. So just be a case of enjoying myself and just filling out and meeting the guys down at the cafe, the Irish Goat. And then just get some egg whites, sit down, have a chat. Show doesn't start till 11. So, yeah. Here we have 6 egg whites. 2 slices of toast, have some butter. That's it. That's the video. Yeah. Right, so look, I'm not a bodybuilder anymore. I'm competing in the NABBA, the body contest competition. I think it's the first body contest competition that Ireland's ever seen. Now I can tell people I'm Mr. Body Contest Ireland if I win this thing. Not that people know what it is, but it's a pretty cool poster. You have Tommy on the far left. You have Brian Hickey. You have Shinners in the middle. You have Billy Byrne in the middle, actually. And then, who else is up there? Don't know who that is, but it's a good poster, minus the body contest thing. But the reason for that being, RDS is prestigious, so I highly doubt they want something affiliated with bodybuilding with all the connotations. So there we go, it's the body contest.
Yeah.
The show is due to start in what, half an hour, give or take. So we're just waiting at the front. It's all the people.
What's your plan for today?
Just gonna graze. I have food with me in the bag. Just graze, just relax. You know, the backstage area is phenomenal. It's the best venue ever. So
how do you stay focused throughout the day when you know you're not on till 6 o'clock or so? It's only 10 o'clock now.
I just don't think about it.
Do you go through the poses or anything like that?
Just go through the poses probably every couple of hours. Just make sure I'm holding condition.
Yeah.
And just like a few people will be coming. So when cameraman Aaron goes off, there will be someone else here, and vice versa. So there'll always be someone keeping the company anyway. So in terms of that's the main thing. Just keep the mind occupied.
Yeah.
Because if you stress, you hold water.
Yeah.
So that's it.
And get your meals in as well.
Get the meals in, and then I'll be done. I think on stage at 6, so should be out of here at 8.
Yeah.
Hopefully. Touch wood.
Yeah.
Touch stone.
Yeah. And we want to improve on from last week with the tan and the glaze.
I think that's...
And the condition's better.
Yeah, so it's just the little finishing touches, you know.
Yeah.
But we're at that point where we actually have the day to do it. Because we were on early last week.
Yeah.
So, like, my tan's 3 hours before I'm on stage. So, 2 hours. So we're in a good place.
Yeah.
So I think it's just enjoy the day. I'll film throughout.
Yeah, we'll check in. We'll check in a couple of hours. See how you're doing. All right. Own out.
So we are waiting. RDS is good a venue as it is. They could fucking open their doors on time. It is 11:30.
Yeah.
We have. There's people here who bought tickets already. There's competitors who want to sit down and fucking rest. And this is highly unprofessional. All it takes is to open the doors and let the people sit in. And bloody well, you know, we've earned it at this point. We've done the diet, we've done the competition, we've done the training. Open the fucking doors. Everyone there, there's a line out the back, line out the corner,
yeah.
Line out the front.
Yeah.
Open the bloody doors. Right, so we finally got our seats. Top notch stuff. Ryan, how does it feel to be in the Vahi flag?
In the what?
Irish Iron flags.
Oh, great.
There we go. We were meant to be on stage together this week, right?
Yeah, but then I got old and broken. Took a sabbatical.
Alright, so we're backstage. Tan is done. Carl, say hi, you're in the video.
So there's only three people in my class. We have Billy over there. We have myself, obviously. And then, yeah, it's just time to eat and tan up and enjoy the process. Work has been done. Feeling good. I'm feeling dry enough. So we'll see how we go. But yeah, big pump up area. It's pretty nice. I have some food with me. Just two classes to go on. Then we'll be good to go. So we're nearly there. We have Billy over here. On the money. Myself. That fella. And then don't know where the other lad's gone. But there's four of us now in our class. So we'll have a bit of fun. And see you on the other side.
This time, simple. Condition. Got feedback at the show, and it's always been the same. It's always the fucking same. It's simple. It's just, oh, you've great shape, you've great size, you've great symmetry. You just need to come in leaner. You just need to, then you'll do well. I get it. Shut the fuck up. I understand it, and I understand I need a coach. You know, I'm not thick. You know, I understand what has to be done. Like, I've been doing this on my own. I fucked up. I've no one else to blame but myself for fucking up. So I'm actually not pissed off about the result of the show, but more so about the fact that people always think I'm going to be the shape guy, the potential guy. So, but the one thing I am going to do, I am going to compete in 2 weeks because I've already paid for it. I am going to come in tighter for it. There's two options I have, and I'm going to tell you those now. So basically, the first one being, I'm going to ask, can I do the NABBA Universe? And can I get coached by Tommy Staunton? Because I have the utmost respect for the man. Number two, if I can't do the Universe, probably ask him for coaching after I take a little break for the off season. Once I've sorted out my job and stuff, I will pay him. I need someone to coach me. I've learned that the hard way. I need some guidance, hold me accountable. Simple as. Second option, I lost to Billy Burney, came first. I would ask him to help me out. But again, I think I need to be not babysat, but I do better when somebody is there in person more so, which Tommy would be. So again, I'm just going to take the show as it is. I'm not pissed off. I know it needs to be done. But the one thing that people keep saying is, oh, don't get any bigger. You're not going to come in better. Fuck off. I am going to come in bigger, and I am going to come in better, because that's bodybuilding. I won't be competing until I'm 27 after these shows. And I'm not going to say anything until it happens, but I am going to secure myself a coach for the off season, and I am going to come in better, because I want this. You know, I've wanted this for years. I love it, but it does hurt when I compete against guys who are in better condition than me. And I know genetically I'm put together better, I'm a better bodybuilder physically, if that makes any sense. I have the muscle bellies, I have the size, I have the shape, and I have the genetics to actually put on more size than they do, you know. So I just need to, I needed this. This was a lesson of hard knocks, if anything, you know. On the upside, I'm only 24, so 26, 27, I'll be back and I'll be a different animal. I just need to reassess, sit down, figure out who I want to work with, and we'll go from there. But yeah, here's what it is, you know. NABBA ran very fast. The show ended when I was actually meant to start. Didn't get posed down or anything. The fucking door didn't open the venue on time either. The venue didn't open the door on time, sorry. Apart from that, great venue, RDS. Great lighting. Just need a coach. End of story. Thought I could do it myself. Problem is, I learned the hard way, you cannot work as a coach with one of your best friends, because you will end up losing that friendship, which I've come close to doing twice, and then you end up not, you won't push as hard. But if you're not, if you have more respect for the coach, you'll work harder, you'll just follow it. So yeah, after these shows, I need time off anyway. I need to sort my workout, I need to sort my outside of bodybuilding life, and once that's in order, let's do it.